Rally GB. The British round of the WRC is one of the oldest and most prestigious rounds in the sport of rallying. And with a backdrop as spectacular as this, you can see why. Well, a move from November to September didn't do much to improve the traditional muddy conditions on the opening day, but it still produced an intriguing six stages of action. Sebastian Loeb began the event knowing the right result could see his Citroën team secure the manufacturer's title with three rounds to spare. So it was a somewhat cautious approach initially in the tricky, slippery conditions. Four-times GB winner Petter Solberg, on the other hand, excels in the Welsh mud, and it was the Norwegian who dominated the early exchanges, taking the first two stage wins.
That's a good start. The car works good, so it feels can be a very interesting weekend, you know.
Well, it was becoming an interesting weekend indeed, and with Solberg's pace fading slightly in stage three, Jari-Matti Latvala immediately took over the forward baton. The winner in Wales last season was suddenly excelling on events he won last year, despite a scare early in the day. Well, the Watch Fords weren't the only Fiestas fighting at the front, however. Mads Usberg was one of the stars of the day in his privately entered machine, running fourth and beating Loeb on two occasions, although he too had a nervous moment when he whacked a rock on stage two. A somewhat subdued performance though from Mikko Hirvonen, never quite able to get the best out of his DS3. The 2007 GB winner was steadily slipping adrift in fifth place. Noin Tanak finished an impressive six on his WRC debut here last year, and despite being hampered by power steering problems throughout the morning, he managed to hold down the same position in his M Sport Run Fiesta. Meanwhile, in the afternoon loop, Loeb was hoping to build an attack on the rally leader Latvala. Try as he might, he just couldn't match the pace of the flying Finns Ford.
I don't know if it's cleaning behind or if we are not fast with our car, but we have no chance.
Are you concerned about this?
No, because I don't need to win.
Well, with the championship at stake, Loeb not too concerned by his inability to match Latvala. He was also passed by a resurgent Petter Solberg, the Norwegian, storming past the world champion with a breathtaking run through stage five. Solberg at his best couldn't match a light-footed Latvala. The Finn continued to show a clean pair of heels to the rest of the field with four straight stage wins to end the day, and the Ford man was in control as we reached the first overnight break.
Trying to make difference to the Citroëns, and I'm pleased with the performance today.
Well, Latvala's advantage stands at just over 12 seconds, with Solberg making it a Ford 1-2, and Loeb more than 21 seconds adrift at the top spot. Usberg will look to keep the pressure on the world champion after his stunning drive on the opening leg. And the second day action is closer to Cardiff in South Wales, heading out to Brecon for three more Welsh classics, including the military ranges at Effant. Something different to finish the day with a new test alongside the famous Celtic Manor course, home of the 2010 Ryder Cup. Well, this is our road order then for the second day. Brazilian miniman Paulo Nobre leads the cruiserweight, followed by multiple South African champion Yanni Habig. Mikko Hirvonen starts down in 10th. then the rest of the top four follow. So if the roads are dry, Østberg, Loeb, Solberg and Latvala should have a clearer line of grip in the gravel. Well, into the first stage of the morning, Julian Porter at stage 7, the Kruchen stage, 19.5 kilometres. We're looking for a drier morning. Well, looks to me as if we had a bit of fog around out there this morning.
That's it. It was a drier morning, actually, stage-wise, but there was some fog and some mist out there. At the stop line of this stage, there was quite a lot, but there was a lot more towards the start as well. So Nasser Al-Attiyah, third into the stage, but we quickly became second with Yanni Hamburg going off the road, getting stuck in the ditch.
He did get stuck in the ditch, unfortunately, couldn't get out. As you see, Yanni Havik not managing to get through stage one of the morning, stage seven of the rally. But Jules, it's very slippery still there, particularly in amongst the trees.
It is very slippery. Thierry Neuville in today's. Obviously, probably going to get a better run today, Thierry, because not first on the road. He will have a line cleaning for him. But he had another problem in here. There's a hole somewhere in the chassis of this car. And in all the puddles and everything, there was mud and water coming in. It was all over the pace notes. It was over his glasses and everything. He wasn't very impressed.
He wasn't happy at all, was he? Now, Oit Tanak, another one, got problems on day one. Julian had power steering problems, intermittent power steering problems, but they've sorted that out today. Good chance for him to build some pace. Mikko Hirvonen, he needs to find some confidence. Difficult first day for him. Struggling with traction in that car. Overnight, they made a lot of changes.
They did. They made a lot of changes, struggling with grip. And I don't think I've ever heard Mikko like kind of going on about this problem. Like yesterday, he said, we just can't get any grip. Let changes make any difference. I mean, looking at it from here, there's plenty of commitment. There's plenty of speed. But let's see what the clock says when he gets to the end.
Historically, you're good in the fog, but not quite as well as you want there. What happened?
Oh, it's just so slippery that we are. I really don't understand why we can't do any times. Really don't understand.
Really big frustration there from Harvin and Julian. But this man, Mads Østberg, really good day one for him. He is flying through the first stage of the morning.
That's it. Obviously, he's trying to catch Loeb. But if he can get his pace, he can give that big gap behind him between him and Mikko Hirvonen. I tell you what, it was a massively in performance through this first stage for Mads Østberg.
Yeah, it's a winning time for Mads Østberg. His first win in a stage since 2009 on gravel.
I'm very pleased with that. It was a tricky stage, very slippery in places, and I think it's getting more and more slippery. So I'm really glad we're in this position now, start position, because the cars behind us will, I think it will be a bit more slippery for them, so it can be a good day, and it started really well.
Well, this man just behind Mads Østberg at the start of the day, Julian, but Østberg throwing down the gauntlet. He's saying, if you want to catch me, Mr. Loeb, you're going to have to do something special in here.
Well, that's it. As I said, he's got this thing. He's always looking forward. He's trying to catch Loeb. It's taking him away from Sebastian Loeb. So, obviously, that new suspension.
We know that when it's very slippery, it's not new. It's not with the new suspension. It has always been like that. Ford are really good, and we struggle a bit, and the condition makes that it's really difficult.
Yeah, really difficult indeed out there. And Sebastian Loeb, well, he wasn't quickest through that stage. Mads Østberg did extend his lead through the first stage of the morning. But we're into stage two, Julian. Not stage two, second stage of the morning. Stage eight.
And are you sure? I still think we're in stage seven, but never mind.
We are still in stage seven.
I tell you what, it was that fast, wasn't he, through stage number seven. You've moved on to stage eight, but yeah, Petter in stage seven here. And now with Jari Matti, obviously the two Ford dominant yesterday. Could they continue this? See what it was going to be. Well, it was going to be a strong start for the Fords. Not the one of these two cars.
Oh, that did. Was that a moment there?
No. That was a massive moment, not a moment.
Jari, a little bit of time out of the boys in and around you. You've done a 38.5, so you're happy with how the day started?
Yeah, it's all right. It just had a couple of moments in the beginning of the stage. It was very, very slippy, honestly. With the fork, I didn't see the cuts that mud had come over the cross of the road. And it was dry, the road, but because the sides are wet and bringing the mud on the top of the surface was very, very slippy in places.
Well, that was Mads Østberg's first gravel stage win for nearly 3 years. Stunning turn of speed sees the Norwegian close up slightly on Loeb, and out front, Latvala continues to edge away from his teammates. Well, the status quo continues for now. Then a pair of classic stages coming up in Eppen and Hatton. We'll be back with more from the second day of Wales Rally GB after the break. Welcome back to a drying Wales Rally GB. And after the first stage of day two this morning, Ford continues to dominate at the front. Latvala is the man in charge, 14 and a half seconds ahead of teammate Petter Solberg. Well, Jules, we are now into stage eight, and this is Chris Atkinson and Stefan Breville. Well, what do you make of the day yesterday? I think they've got to improve things today.
Yeah, they have. Well, they've got to improve things. They're very high over the jump. This was the jump that was used in a power stage last year. Last year they went left. This time they're going right and up out onto the ranges there. But yeah, Chris Atkinson says, I feel even though he's talking the right show, I still think he needs to be quicker.
Matthew Wilson back in the Cumbrian backed M Sport Fiesta. Julian, good to see him back in the championship. A decent day for him yesterday.
That's it, yeah. It's been a good day. Look how bumpy it is there with the cuts. Matthew, he's fully on it though, isn't he?
He really is. Evgeny Novikov, Ilkka Meiner next to him this weekend. Doing a really decent job out there. No real problems so far for Evgeny.
He was in that battle for sixth place with Ott Tanak. And Evgeny went off a little bit there last year, so he's got it a lot better.
But this man's having absolutely no problems. It's remarkable just how well Latvala is doing in this rally. Wasn't showing this kind of form coming into the event, but he really is dominating, Julian.
So he actually made a small mistake on the start line in this stage. He had near enough stalled the car. So I tell you what, that was then a little bit of punishment probably for a co-driver, because it's going to be a full-on assault for the rest of it.
Well, you can see conditions changing. This is the second stage of the morning. No problems with fog. Really dry surface there, Julian. A bit of dust maybe even being thrown up by the cars.
Sheer commitment, Jari Matti. I remember all on soft tyres this morning again, rattling through those soft tyres that they've got.
So Solberg still in second place, 15.2 seconds behind Jari Matti Latvala, and Loeb 23.1 seconds off the lead. Heading in for our first run now, Jules, through the halfway stage. This one of the drivers' favourite stages, a real, real classic.
Dear me, that was a bit of a moment. That was over like the Dixies area. This is where Andreas Mikkelsen famously rolled a few years ago. In his focus, you remember
Granholm,
that?
Remember Granholm went off here a few years ago?
Granholm was on the tarmac road just to the other side.
Man, the tyres are looking warm. What was it you said?
Well, I paid for them, so I better use them properly then.
You've used them properly, that's for sure. They're very, very worn.
Yeah, I knew that before the stage, but I thought they were going to last the whole stage, so we just tried there.
Yeah, man, big push. Tyre wear and issue, Jules, through these stages. Really drying up through the halfway stage, and these soft compound Michelins just struggling in these conditions.
Well, massively struggling, particularly on the Citroëns. They just can't match the Fords. I don't know why, but all of a sudden the tables have been turned.
It was very noticeable, wasn't it? Particularly Nasser Alatia, Sebastian Loeb.
Sebastian, the front tyres are worn on the outside edge, they're worn on the inside edge. Two brand new ones in the back. Why didn't you use them?
Hard.
Yeah, but it's dry now.
Not enough.
Not enough.
No, not enough for the hard compound. It's too, here it's dry, but in the forest it's really muddy. And so hard compound in the mud is really bad, so we couldn't use them.
Well, we're riding with Chris Patterson and Petter Solberg now. Julian, Solberg still under a bit of pressure from Sebastian Loeb. Real pressure, in fact, from Sebastian Loeb.
I see he's just starting to lose, just tense, like yesterday in second stages, just tense. Just little mistakes just here and there, and I don't know, he's neat. I mean, the speed there doesn't look like he's going slowly, but he just is losing just fractions to Sebastian Loeb.
A great aerial shot, this one, following our rally leader, Jari Matti. No problems for him, Julian. It is just a wonderfully composed drive from Latvala.
But it is, remember, he hasn't won since Sweden. And let's just listen as Mika calls the notes for Jari Matti on the, basically climbing up the top of halfway. I bet you'd be scared if you were in there.
I was actually in a mini World Rally car this week, Julian. And
were you
right,
scared?
Terrified. With Chris Atkinson. Now, still with the Jari Matti Latvala, making it look so straightforward.
Jari, really, really neat and tidy here. And he'll tell you what, he'd be helping those tyres along by no big slides or anything like that.
soft tyres still. His driving style a few years ago, Julian, and he'd have chewed straight through these tyres. He was so aggressive, he's calmed it down a lot.
That's it, when he's through the finish, it's another stage win for him.
Yari, I'm hearing your fastest so far. The tyres on the Ford seem to be considerably better condition than the tyres on the Citroens.
Yeah, that's surprising. I don't understand that, because in Finland we had a problem. My tyres were wearing a lot, and it just felt really, really other way around. So it's interesting how it's that way in Wales.
What do you think's different? What's changed from August till now?
Well, we haven't changed so much, but we have changed the balance of the car at the rear, but nothing major, nothing big. It's just some changes. What we have been playing the effort that we can do quick changes with the car, but for me, we haven't seen difference on tyre wear.
Well, after stage nine, then Latvala's lead up to 22.2 seconds over his teammate, but Solberg, the intimidating presence of Sebastian Loeb just behind him, under 4 seconds off second place. Østberg remains in a comfortable fourth ahead of Hirvonen. Well, they were back to Cardiff for service and then out for the second running through the Cruachan stage. Stage 10, Julian, and that fog that we saw the morning well and truly lifted this afternoon.
That was it, and it was a big dilemma for the guys back in the service. It was a lot drier, we hadn't had any rain. What do you take, softs or hards? Well, the majority of them, Ken, came out on their soft tyres. Mads Osberg taking softs, this time taking two spares. And we know what he was saying yesterday about taking two spares. He wasn't happy, and look how sideways the car is, that extra 20, 22 kilos in the back. He wasn't a happy bunny.
Yeah, the weight, that extra weight, Julian, just making the car respond differently, particularly
it's
through
the corner. Big pendulum. Watch him when he goes through tight corners. The back end's wanting to come out much more.
The biggest problem for Osberg was he knew when he left service the car was going to be difficult to handle, and it was difficult for him in his head, I think, Julian, this afternoon.
Yeah, I spoke to him since, and it was his decision. It wasn't kind of forced into it. It was his choice. So, I mean, if you look in the tight corners, he just wants to move out in the rear end.
Sixth gear, it's almost flat out, so narrow. You can see it's still, although we've not had any rain, still quite slippery.
Mads has not the usual happy smiley face there at the end of the stage. Why?
Oh, it's just very frustrating. We push really hard, but it's not happening. I don't feel confident enough to set good times, so I'm not happy now.
Is this down to the weight distribution?
Yes.
Well, certainly he wasn't particularly happy, Mads Østberg, but he managed to finish the day in fourth place. On to stage 11 and 12, the second running of the Evans and halfway stages. Julian, and let's wait and see who's up next. Whoa, it's a flying
Frenchman.
Sebastian Loeb. Yeah. It's a flying Frenchman. Sebastian Loeb. You know, he got very close when the mornings looked a bit of Solberg. 3.8 seconds, I think, the difference was. But he wasn't able to continue that in the afternoon's loop of stages.
No, he wasn't. He just... Sebastian Loeb, we know, never gives. So just look at the speed down here. My word. That is incredibly fast. But yeah, Sebastian Loeb never gives up. But he just... Again, he just was struggling for the Citroens, not just him and Mikko were struggling. I mean, Mikko was pretty fraught at stage ends, to be fair. He was completely lost. And Sebastian, he doesn't need to win the rally. We know he's got plenty of points, but he likes to win. And I don't know, it's just not how he wants it.
It's really not how he wants it. He wants to be at the front. He always wants to be at the front. He wants to be pushing for the win. He has given up on catching Latvala, that's for sure. But even although he finished the day in third place, he still is very much looking at Solberg.
Best condition tyre at the end of this stage so far?
We had two spares, so we used it in this one. Well, we've done what we could. It's hard for the tyre, but it was okay in this one.
What can you do tomorrow about Loeb and Solberg? Sorry, about Latvala and Solberg?
Latvala nothing, and Solberg, it depends of a lot of this one, but I think if the gap will be difficult tomorrow.
Rupert Solberg and Chris Patterson having a decent afternoon, Julian, out on the ranges. A bit of pressure on them at lunchtime service. Loeb, that gap way, way down, but they responded well this afternoon.
They did respond well, and they had to. And I mean, it's still close, and it's still anybody's game for that second place at the end of it. But I mean, so quick here. He's just incredibly fast. Pedder obviously having to look after those tyres like everybody. Don't worry, they all went off there last year, not this year.
I was just noticing that huge rock on the inside. You have to be really careful with your notes here and mark the places where the dangers, and there are plenty of dangers up there on the ranges.
There's another one there. Don't cut, you know what I mean? It's so tricky. But yeah, Petter's had a great afternoon, you know, a really good afternoon for Petter.
I think more than that, Julian. I think he's had a great rally so far. Not a single mistake from Solberg, no major mistakes from Latvala either, but I'm impressed by Solberg's performance so far this weekend. That is a quick section.
I'm kind of speechless there. I was thinking, oh my word, it's so quick.
That's it. Asked Loeb what he could do about you two in the Fords tomorrow. He says nothing about Latvala. He said it depends what Petter does, whether I can do anything about him.
Well, I'm sure, you know, it is a close fight, and I'm sure it will be a hard fight anyway, you know, to the bitter end. You know, it's just a few seconds, and I will keep on fighting. So I'm ready. Yeah.
So Solberg did finish the day in second place. He's got a job to do tomorrow. So does this man, Jos Jari-Matti Latvala. Impressive drive from this afternoon, but he got the right choice with his tyres.
That was it. Four softs on the car when he came out of service. Two hards in the boot. And in the second stage of the three of the gravel, so that would be stage 11, he put those hard tyres on the front, and they work wonders. This is this stage here. Really dry, really good. Got great grip, great traction from those new tyres. He then would run them into the final stage as well.
A really clever tyre choice from Ford and from Jari-Matti Latvala. To be fair, Julian, we haven't seen that this year. We've seen Ford, Latvala, Solberg making the wrong tyre choice more often than not. But this time today, Latvala got it spot on.
He did. In the last gravel stage, he was saying that under the trees, in the slippy stuff, he did lose a little bit of time, but he didn't panic because he knew he could get it all back in the final 3 or 4 kilometres when it was dry. So, Jari-Matti, wise head on young shoulders.
Not so young shoulders these days, but certainly a wise head, Julian. Yeah, but he's showing some consistency through this rally. Here we go.
Jari, you're just studying the times there. Your tyres look absolutely beautiful compared to everyone else's. I see it's the hards. When did they go on?
The hards went on for the short stage, for the second stage, and pretty much I think it's I don't know what was the right overall. I think the time difference is, if you look all these three stages, it's been the same, but for sure I gained on the short one, but then I lost in the halfway in the last first 6-8 kilometers. I lost some time, then towards the end it was fine, but overall I think it was the same for everybody.
Well, on to the very final stage of the day. A short blast around the famous Celtic Manor Hotel. It really is a great place there. The Ryder Cup venue in 2010, and really not many changes, or not any changes, in the leaderboard coming through this final short spectator stage.
High speed, though. I mean, you still get caught out. There's a lot of rocks and a lot of stones to hit, but I tell you what, brought a lot of fans into it.
Yeah, great addition to Wales Rally GB. Very popular spot, this one. So at the end of the day, Latvala's lead over his teammate Petter Solberg, a healthy 24.5 seconds. Loeb just 6.4 seconds behind Solberg in third place. Østberg has held on to fourth, but Hirvonen continues to struggle in fifth. So another stunning day then in the forests of South Wales for Jari-Matti Latvala. Join us tomorrow to see if he can make it two wins in a row on Wales Rally GB.